Alleluia, 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 alleluia. Jesus.
Like the Christians of the second reading, we too could take those words and say, I am for St. Francis of Assisi, I am for St. Margaret Mary's, I am for the fastest mass, I am for whatever might suit my likes, but really we are for Christ. We have to have a unity in our diversity. Our expressions of faith are many and varied, but we have to keep our, if you will, eyes on the prize of heaven. Our task as a people of God is to let the light of Christ rise in our hearts. And so we pray to Jesus, give us a heart like yours. Because our hearts can go all over the place. We have this meeting that we call the Mass to remind ourselves, what are we doing? Where are we going? And who is this about? As Catholics, we need to be people of prayer. We need to be people of unity. We're doing that with the merger, certainly. We need to be people of understanding, with faith and intellect working together. But as the pastor, I have to look and say, well, what's wrong? I get lots of complaints all the time, and I'm used to that, and it doesn't bother me most of the time. And then sometimes it does, but I have to say, what's the situation that warrants the most attention? Whereas Pope Francis would say, who are the poorest of the poor among us? And I have to say, in my experience as pastor, things change all the time. In the previous parish where I was in Bloomington, it was mental illness because people were ashamed, there was a social stigma, and yet there was a preponderance of people suffering from mental illness. But now in South Windsor, I find the poorest of the poor are people with opioid addiction. They begin as young people with an injury, they have OxyContin, and next thing you know, they're stealing prescription drugs. So many families suffer from this. And to address this issue, I'd ask that you pray that the parish can respond in a way to help these families that are so afflicted. If we start in prayer, we will indeed be a success. All sorts of governmental services are provided, but really, we have to allow the light of Christ to rise in the hearts of all among us, especially the young. So I ask you to please pray as we move forward, calling upon people with the expertise, but also the care and the time and the fervor to go the long run with these families that suffer so much. In my short time as pastor, I buried 5 young people who died from heroin overdoses. It's unnecessary. And these people, all of them are in college, all of them are on the way to do something wonderful with their lives, and their lives ended because of that terrible scourge. You can actually, I believe, use the word that terrible evil. But when we look at the meaning of life, and if we have it, we don't look elsewhere. So what do? Redouble our efforts to help the parents who are the first teachers of the faith and the ways of living, to make sure that we care for those among us, and make sure that we understand so that we can defend our own faith. That's very important. It can be a little bit upsetting to hear news like this on a Sunday morning, but we have to remember those who are most in need. I had the privilege of journeying to Washington to see both a protest and an inauguration. I'm an independent, so it didn't bother me either way. But I said, what's the problem that hurts us the most? And I think it's the prescription drug issue. I see it again and again. And we all know that if you have one addict in the family, it affects the entire family. We're all affected by it. So I'd ask, please, to begin with prayer. So how do we go about teaching the young ones prayer? I have just the solution. There's a thing called the rosary. And many of the children, young ones, like to wear it. The girls told me, oh, we're accessorizing. I said, oh, I thought that meant, you know, comes with accessories, like appliances or something. But no. They put the rosary, they pull it over their head, and I said, well, how do you pray it? Pray it? What do you mean, pray it? It's jewelry. It is not jewelry. This is the 100th anniversary year of Our Lady of Fatima. She was over here for Christmas. She came back. And our children have to know how to do that. They have to be able to understand the mysteries of the rosary in a beautiful way. I recently returned from a pilgrimage to Fatima with my mother, and I asked the Portuguese priest with me, I said, I need 700 rosaries. He said, no, we have 700 children in our parish, and we have to give them the meaning of life. We have to give them the tools to go through life without having to search for other things. So I got 700 rosaries for $500. Such a deal. We're going to try, and when the weather is good, bring the children out here to pray the rosary, bring them in here when the weather is poor, but mostly, say, ask your family at home to pray the rosary with you. We need time in prayer. We need that school of prayer. We need to have vibrant interior lives to let that light of Christ rise within us. They don't then sit around and say, I'm bored. No, because instead they're grounded in the faith. Now, going on pilgrimage with your mother is holy and daunting. If you remember, your mother says, now, if you're good, I'll buy you an ice cream. I said, I'm 50. Okay, I'll buy you a toy. We went to Italy, off of Italy. So in Venice, I learned they sell jewelry. In Florence, they sell pocketbooks. And in Rome, they sell shoes. And I said, Mom, that's St. Peter's Basilica. She said, does it have a gift shop? Then she told me, quick, take a picture of me praying so everyone will believe that, you know, I was here. At one point, she went up to the border patrol. Now, the border patrol guys are always kind of touchy, TSA type of. This guy has a gun and a sword and epaulets and very important. And I'm talking to the guy in Italian or Spanish, where it was. And my mother leans over and says, excuse me, could you upgrade us? I'd like more leg room. And the guy yelled, I'm not a travel agent. So after we got out of jail in Italy, it was a wonderful time. I said, Ma, we got to go into this beautiful church. But the stores are still open. I said, come in. I said, Ma, oh, this is nice. I said, yeah, see. It was a very good balance. We ate well. She shopped very well. I took a selfie of me in a shoe store. In a mirror, surrounded by boots and shoes and pop. It was just like my childhood, except my brothers weren't there, it was no fun. But we had great experiences of prayer. We saw the Holy Father, Pope Francis, give a very serious talk about the situation in Turkey. As you remember, New Year's Eve, they had the attack in the nightclub, and then gave a greeting to all the people that were gathered in different groups, and then at the end, gave a solemn blessing in Latin. And concluded by saying, have a nice lunch. That's Catholic. We talk about what's important, we talk about the meaning of life, and we eat. So downstairs today after Mass, between rounds, is the caterer. We have breakfast food for you. Now, I urge you to come down live, because you should meet each other. You're awfully nice. I don't know if you've met each other yet. You're awfully nice. Make it a goal to meet one new person. It's easier if you have children, because they'll talk to anyone. But if we're older, we're calling, I don't know, who's that? Who's this? Go downstairs, grab something to eat, and you can leave as soon as possible. Don't worry. Why? Because we have a lot of food. We have a lot of food, and it's for you. And that's Catholic, to make sure you have more than enough. Press down, spilling over, filling with garments, like in the song. As people of prayer, we have to, having prayed, have a sense and experience of unity. We have to understand the task ahead of us, but we have to be fed by the Eucharist and by bagels. There's no waffles. Bagels, danishes, coffee, juice. It's very good. You have to be nourished to go about the task of living as a Christian. And you have to meet other Christians to have those conversations about what do we do with the problems and how do we celebrate the blessings we have in our life. I think you're good at that. You're very good at that. Your prayers, your effort, your example helps others have the light of Christ rise in their hearts.